guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I created this look right here. It's a little dark, so if you'd like to see how I got this look, then please keep watching.
I'm gonna go with my eyebrows first, and I'm gonna use this pomade, and it's the Cabrow Benefit cream gel brow in the color 2. I haven't used this in a while, so I'm gonna try to put this towards the end of my brow and then put a lighter color towards the front. I just went in and did my brows, and then I took an angled brush and took some concealer and just tried to carve out my brows. And now I'm just going in with the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre, and I'm just gonna put this all over my lid, get rid of all the color, and be able to blend eyeshadows good over top. In the market for a new eyeshadow primer, I would highly suggest the MAC Paint Pot. It's really blendable, and I just really enjoy it. Okay, now I'm just taking a fluffy brush to blend some translucent powder over top of that MAC Paint Pot, just so that it's all kind of set. With eyeshadow, I'm just gonna cut my eyelashes to fit my eyelids. So these are the Ardell Wispy multi-pack. It's got a little bit of sticky on it right now, and you just want to pop it on your lid and try to measure out whether or not you need to cut any off, because you don't want it to be too big. So I'm just trying to fit it. Well, what I recommend, learning from my own mistakes, is to line up where you want your lash to start, and then see on the end how much you want to cut. Obviously, if you're not very familiar with doing this, you want to go as slow as possible, because you can cut off too much.
I'm gonna cheat, and I'm gonna use my palette from my March BoxyCharm. I haven't done my BoxyCharm unboxing yet, so you guys will see a sneak peek. This is from the brand Pure and BoxyCharm. It's a beautiful palette with a big mirror and lots of juicy colors. I already had my idea in my head that I was gonna sort of start with an orange in the crease and then go really dark and try to smoke it out. And I've never used these colors before. I just swatched this black one here. So I'm gonna go in with this orange color right here, and this is called Nakey. I'm just gonna pop this right into the crease. I really like using orange as a crease color. I find that it looks really nice underneath other colors, especially like dark colors. I'm really digging this color, and it's applying nicely, blending easily as well. BoxyCharm is awesome. I'm just gonna take this flat shader brush, and I'm gonna jump into this dark brown color down here. This is called Duet. And I'm just gonna start adding this all over the lid. This is a very dark brown. It almost looks black. And then I'm gonna try to wing it out. I'm gonna use the other side of this brush and dip back into that brown color and just try to blend it a bit. Oops.
So you don't have to worry so much about this messy area here because we'll go in and clean it after with a wipe. Now I'm going to jump into the black color in the palette, which is called Boxy Black, and it's got some sparkles in it. And I just cleaned off my brush. And I'm just going to start adding this along the lash line and then bring it up a little bit. I really find that when you layer a smoky eye, it really brings dimension. Ooh, pretty. It's a nice black. So I'm gonna dip back into that brown with a fluffy brush and just kind of blend all the colors together at the top. Grab a clean fluffy brush. Go back and forth, blend these together. See, now the eye may look intimidating because it's so dark, but once you add a bit more of that orange on top, I think it looks really nice. So now I'm just going back in with that orange color to kind of add it back because I feel like I lost it from that dark. Take that brush. I'm not going to add any more black because there's still some product, and I'm just going to try to wing this look out a bit. So just pulling all those black dark colors together. And a nice makeup wipe. I'm just cleaning it up. And just making that straight line across. Same thing up here. Now I'm just leaving my eyes for now, and I'm moving on to the face. I got this sample. It's a Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer. It's primer and moisturizer in one. I did use a face mask earlier and then moisturize, but you can never have too much moisture on your face. Tarte Rainforest of Sea Radiance Drops. This is another sample I got from Sephora. Now you can mix this in with your products. You can use it on its own, but it's basically just to kind of give your face a more dewy look. So I'm just gonna try to apply this right now before my foundation. It comes in a little dropper, which is cute. I've never used this before. Okay. All right, so I'm just sort of applying this with a brush all over the skin. I definitely look dewy already. Foundation, I'm gonna use my Fenty foundation. This is in the color 150. It's kind of a neutral color. I'm gonna use my headband for this part. All right. So with what I said, with it drying quickly, I'm just gonna add it to one side of the face at a time. I find if you add it all over and then try to go in and blend it, by the time you get to the other side of your face, it's gonna be already drying and a bit harder to blend out. So trying to stay away from the eyeshadows and your brow, just blending this all in. I really love this foundation, it's so pretty. I'm just trying to blend it into the hairline as well. Just doing one side of the face. Don't worry too much about under your eye because you're adding concealer there and you don't want to have too much product there. Okay, now we'll do the other side. Oh, bring my hair. I definitely think that, those radiance drops made my face really dewy already, so we'll see how it acts the foundation on top. I just want to go kind of into your ear and down the neck. Okay. I love this foundation, it's so pretty. You just have to work kind of fast. Keep on blending. I'm gonna go in with my concealer. So we're gonna go under the eyes. Try to get rid of that darkness down there. And up the nose on both sides. And then you want to highlight the center of your face, just like so. And then I'm just using the same blender and just going to go in and blend this all out. Bake my face a bit, so I'm just gonna take another damp sponge. I'm just gonna go in with my Marcel, which is just a drugstore powder, and I'm just going to get some on my sponge and kind of hit into the under eyes. Just leave that there for a moment. I'm gonna chisel out my cheekbones. Alright, so we're gonna let that bake for a bit. I'm gonna take a big brush and just wipe away the powder. Kind of pat it into the face a little. I'm just adding my orange underneath here. Yeah, you kind of need that dark color also, just that liner runs a bit. That way this is kind of hiding it. Adding this highlighter as an inner corner highlight. This is the Mary Lou Luminizer, the brand The Balm Cosmetics. My mother-in-law actually gave this to me from her Ipsy bag. So I am just using it to highlight, which I really do like this color. More. Step one with the eyelashes, you want to curl your natural lashes so that they blend upwards with the lashes that you're putting on. Obviously, our natural lashes, well, unless you're really lucky, don't curl up. So you just want to curl them up so that they're going to blend. And if it's Bad Gal Bang mascara, I find this mascara really tacky. Now you don't want to put too much on, so I'm just going to put a couple strokes of my mascara in this way. You're going to cling to the fake falsies. You want to leave your glue on there to get tacky for at least 30 seconds. I've got the Duo Clear Glue. Had time for my mascara to dry. Now the other trick of the trade that I've learned is you don't want to be looking straight ahead, you want to be looking down. So I'm just going to hold my lash like this. The shorter one is for your inner corner. And you're looking down. And just pop it on. Now once you've popped it on, even if it's not completely close to the lash, just kind of let it sit for a moment. And then we can go in with our tweezers and try to clump together our real lashes with the fake lashes. So I'm going to use my favorite one, which is a little dark. So I don't want to bring this too far down my face. It's just enough to go from the ear. Do the other one, which is the Butter Bronzer, and it's a bit lighter, and I'm just going to kind of go over everything. All my bronzer with this guy. Favorite blush. This is the Party Tarte blush. This is my favorite blush brush. Nice and big. Tap into there. Lips. I just put a sugar scrub on because they're a bit dry. And I'm just going to go into this highlight again. And highlight my skin. I want my brush to be wet. So this is the completed look. I'm really digging the red lips and the bold smoky eye and the crazy hair. I'm really excited. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel before you go. Most important part. That makeup ain't going nowhere. Bye!